हेलो एवरीबॉडी, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर पी श्रीवास्तव एंड टुडे विल डिस्कस अबाउट द पेक्टोरल रीजन। द पेक्टोरल रीजन इज लाइज ऑन द फ्रंट ऑफ द चेस्ट एंड इट इज एसेंशियली कंसिस्ट ऑफ ए स्ट्रक्चर अपर लिम दिस साइड दिस पूरा होल एरिया इज नोन एज अपर लिम एंड एंटीरियर लेटरल चेस्ट होल। इट मीन्स फ्रंट ऑफ द चेस्ट, दिस इज अ फ्रंट ऑफ द चेस्ट एंड अपर लिम पार्ट ऑफ द अपर लिम and this is known as anterior lateral wall of chest. This all consist of pectoral region. Here is the mammary gland is lies. First landmark. Now we see in this region the clavicle. This is the clavicle which lies horizontally and it's separate root of the neck. Here is the this area is known as root of neck and this is the chest wall. So it's separate from front of the chest to root of the neck and this bone is subcutaneous. Really this is a medial side. Medially it articulates with the sternum known as sternoclavicular joint and it laterally is known as acromioclavicular joint. And sternoclavicular joint, this joint is marked by the esternocleidomastoid muscles. Where is the esternocleidomastoid originated, right? Second is the jugular notch. So this portion, yeah, jugular notch, you can say intraclavicular notch, yeah, supraesternal notch, because this is the sternum and this portion is known as supraesternal, and just above it a depression is present is known as supraesternal notch, yeah, jugular notch, right? And this is situated between the both clavicle, right and left. So here is the clavicle is present and this area is known as, this is a clavicle, right? And between the both clavicle, here is the depression is present is known as jugular notch. So this portion is known as jugular notch. It also known as intraclavicular notch or suprasternal because it present superior to the sternum, so known as supraesternal notch, right? And it lies between the medial end of clavicle, this is a medial end, superior border of manubrium sterni, right? Now the sternal angle, this is the sternal angle, this portion is known as sternal angle. This is the part of manubrium sterni, this is a manubrium sterni, and this is the sternum, this is a Jiffy process. Sternal angle, yeah, angle of Lois is a felt transverse, it is about 5 cm below the jugular notch. This is a jugular notch and it lies, this is a sternal angle, right? And it marks the manubrium sternal joint. This area is known as manubrium sternal joint because manubrium and sternum are both joint together, so this area is known as manubrium sternal joint, right? And it is a lies below the 5 cm from the jugular notch. Identification of second costal cartilage and other rib are identified by counting downward from the second rib. So this is a second rib which are identified by the sternal angle, yeah, manubrium sternal joint, right? Now epigastric fossa, so this area is known as epigastric fossa. It overlies Jiffy process and it is also known as infrasternal angle, right? This is also known as infrasternal angle or pit of stomach, epigastric fossa. It overlies by the Jiffy process. Now nipples, nipple is marked variable in the position in female. But in male and in immature female, it is usually lies in fourth intercostal space. This identification by the use of midclavicular line and from the fourth intercostal space. It means this area, right? So this is marked by the both from the fourth intercostal space and medial to the midclavicular line. Right now, what is a midclavicular line? So midclavicular line is a middle of the clavicle and tip of 9th costal cartilage. Right, this is a mid portion of clavicle, a middle of the clavicle. This portion is known as infraclavicular fossa. It is situated between lateral and middle third of the clavicle. So this portion is known as infraclavicular fossa. Now, coracoid process. This is a coracoid process. This is a coracoid. It is a lies below the 2 to 3 centimeter from the clavicle. This is a clavicle and this is a coracoid. Acromion. This is a acromion, and acromion is a flattened piece of the bone, and this is lies subcutaneous, forming the top of the shoulder. Right, and it articulates with the clavicle, known as acromioclavicular joint. Now deltoid. So deltoid, it is a triangular muscle. This is a triangular muscles. It extends vertically from the acromion to the deltoid tuberosity of the humerus. So this is a deltoid tuberosity, and this is a triangular muscles. This is known as deltoid muscles. And axilla. Axilla, it also known as a armpit, is a pyramidal space. This is a axilla. This portion is known as axilla. It is a pyramidal space between the arm and chest. This is a arm position, and this is a chest. This area is known as axilla. Right? When the arm is raised, the floor of axilla is rises. The anterior fold, this is a anterior fold, and this is an anterior fold. The anterior fold contain lower border of pectoris major, and posterior fold contain latissimus dorsi. Medial wall, this is a biserratus anterior muscles. Fourth ribs covered by serratus anterior muscles. So this portion, this portion is known as medial wall of the axilla, and it which form by the serratus anterior muscles, okay, which cover the four ribs. Lateral wall, it is a narrow and formed by the short head of biceps and the coracobacillus. Mid axillary line. So mid axillary line, this portion is known as mid axillary line. It is situated between the anterior and posterior fold of axilla. This is a part of the surface landmark of pectoral region. Now, next, a following areas is there. First is the skin, superficial fascia, deep fascia, muscles, vessels. Okay, so after inside of skin, a superficial fascia you can see, right? And the superficial fascia, it is a contain moderate amount of fat, and it is a continuous with that of surrounding regions, right? It contains subcutaneous muscles known as platysma, cutaneous nerve derived from the cervical plexus and form intercostal nerve, cutaneous vessels, it is derived from the internal thoracic and posterior intercostal arteries, lymphatics, superficial lymph node, adipose tissues and fats, suspensory ligamenta, and last one is the breast and mammary gland. The breast or mammary gland lies in superficial fascia of the pectoral region. Now, cervical plexus of intercostal nerve and cutaneous supply the superficial part of the skin, right? So this is a division. Here is the transverse cervical nerve, major occipital, great auricular, and suprascapular nerve is there, right? Now, deep fascia. Deep fascia is also known as pectoral fascia. This is a pectoral fascia, and extension and tracing of the deep fascia, we will see the following muscles: pectoral major, pectoral minor, subclavius, serratus anterior, ribs, clavicle sternum, upper part of humerus, and clavipectoral fascia. Right. So now, we see in diagram. This muscles is known as pectoral major muscles. Right. So pectoral major muscles, it has following heads. This is a clavicular head because it origin from the clavicle. Medial two-third of a clavicle, right? This is a medial two-third of the clavicle, the clavicle head. Second is the एंटीरियर सर्फेस ऑफ मेनुब्रियम स्टर्नम टू सिक्स कॉस्टल कॉटिलेज. दिस इज अ एंटीरियर सर्फेस ऑफ मेनुब्रियम एंड सिक्स कॉस्टल कॉटिलेज एंड सेकेंड टू सिक्स कॉस्टल कॉटिलेज इट इंसर्टेड इन टू लेटरल लीफ ऑफ बाइसेप्टल ग्रुप. दिस इज अ बाइसेप्टल ग्रुप ऑफ द ह्यूमरस. हेयर इज द पेक्टोरिस मेजर इंसर्टेड इन लेटरल लीफ. राइट नाउ सेकेंड इज द पेक्टोरिस माइनर मसल. दिस इज अ पेक्टोरल माइनर मसल्स. वी कैन सी दिस ओरिजिन आर इन थ्री हेडिंग्स. थर्ड फोर्थ एंड फिफ्थ रिब्स नियर द कॉस्टोकॉन्ड्रल जंक्शन एंड इट इंसर्टेड इन टू द कोराकोइपर्स. द ओरिजिन पॉइंट ऑफ द सब क्लेवियस मसल्स नोन एज कॉस्टोकॉन्ड्रल जंक्शन एंड नाउ इंसर्टेड इन टू द सब क्लेवियन ग्रूव इन मिडिल वन थर्ड ऑफ द क्लेविकल. तो दिस इज अ मिडिल वन थर्ड ऑफ द क्लेविकल वेयर इज द इंसर्टेड सब क्लेवियन मसल्स एंड दिस इज द मिडिल एंड वेयर इज द ओरिजिनेटेड पेक्टोरिस मेजर मसल्स. नाउ सो दिस इज द क्लेविपेक्टोरल फासिया. यू कैन सी हेयर दिस रीजन. हेयर इज द क्लेविपेक्टोरल फासिया इज प्रेजेंट. राइट एंड दिस इज अ साइड ऑफ द सेफेलिक वेन. लेटरल साइड ऑफ द चेस्ट वॉल. इट ओरिजिनेटेड फ्रॉम एट डिजिटेशन फ्रॉम द अपर एट रिब इन मिड एक्जिलरी प्लेन. अपर एट रिब इट ओरिजिनेटेड फ्रॉम अपर एट रिब इन द मिड एक्जिलरी प्लेन एंड इट कवरिंग द इंटरवेन इंटरकॉस्टल मसल्स. राइट इट इंसर्टेड इन टू दिस एरिया. दिस इज अ कॉस्टल सर्फेस एंड दिस इज अ मीडियल बॉर्डर. दिस इज अ मीडियल बॉर्डर ऑफ द स्कुपला वेर इज द इंसर्टेड ऑफ सीरेटस एंटीरियर मसल्स. राइट अप्लाइड एनाटॉमी विनिंग ऑफ द स्कुपला. दिस इज अ मीडियल बॉर्डर एंड इट इज अनड्यूली प्रोमिनेंट एंड पैरालिसिस ऑफ द सीरेटस एंटीरियर मसल्स. राइट तो वॉट यू कैन टेस्टिंग फॉर द पैरालिसिस ऑफ सीरेटस एंटीरियर. वैन यू टोल्ड द पेशेंट फॉर द फॉरवर्ड प्रेशर with the hand against the wall, against resistance offered by the examiner, make the medial border and the inner angle of the scapula prominent. Inner angle of the scapula and medial border is the prominent and is called winning of scapula. Okay. Thank you. For the next topic.